réputée à Los Angeles, voire la plus touristique, dans un quartier populaire. On est un petit peu dans notre Times Square à New York. Ici, tous les touristes du monde entier se retrouvent pour admirer la série d'étoiles qui est inscrite et gravée sur le sol avec différents petits logos qui représentent à la fois les plus grands réalisateurs, les plus grands musiciens, des comédiens du monde du théâtre, des acteurs. Bref, ici, on est dans le fame et le glamour, mais gravé au sol. You're someone else, and you know, you look like Michael Jackson, basically.
It feels really good.
Yeah? Because, you feel like you're him?
Because I'm loved all over the place. I mean, if I go anywhere in the world, I am loved by total strangers, you know?
It's unbelievable.
Because Michael Jackson represents love.
Right, and everybody's loved him. So now, since you look like Michael Jackson,
yeah.
We better dance like Michael Jackson.
Oh, you want to dance?
Of course. I want to dance.
Oh, that's superb. Okay, great. Why don't we do this, right? And then do a turn. Oh, you're pretty good. And do a kick. Oh, pretty good.
Do you know how to do this, right? Like,
oh, pretty good. You know what? You're better than me.
Maybe I'm gonna dress like Michael Jackson.
Show me the moonwalk.
At the moonwalk, but yeah. I mean, I can't do the moonwalk with my heels.
Oh, that's true. You better run, you better do what you can.
Don't wanna see no blood, don't be a macho man. You I could dance all day here. Do what you can, so beat it. But you wanna be bad, just beat it. Don't wanna want to beat it. Alors maintenant, nous voilà devant le Chinese Theater, un endroit très connu puisque c'est ici que sont posées toutes les empreintes des superstars. Il y a à peu près 200 empreintes et aujourd'hui il ne reste que quelques mini spots pour des nouvelles célébrités. C'est ici que se déroulaient les Oscars dans les années 40. Aujourd'hui ça se passe au Kodak Theater qui est vraiment la porte à côté. Alors vous allez voir, l'endroit est assez kitsch à l'intérieur, mais en tout cas ça fait toujours rêver. Quite something to be inside the Chinese Theater.
Yes, this is a beautiful theater, and we've been open now since 1927.
Wow, yeah. Back in the days.
Mm-hmm, yep, so this is where most of the big movie premieres take place at, the hand and footprint ceremonies. It's a huge, huge part of Hollywood's history.
So anyone can also come. I mean, the public can come. Mm-hmm. Usually it's open like around 1 p.m. and you can watch a movie.
Yeah, we're open for regular movies on almost a daily basis. Our show times run from, you know, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the afternoon to about, you know, 10 o'clock at night. So we have movies here on a regular basis.
So can we see the space?
Mm-hmm. So back in 1927, Sid Grauman opened this up to be this huge movie palace for the stars, for the premieres and for the regular public to enjoy as well. And all the artwork and architecture you see inside here is all designed on a Chinese theme and influence. And so when you come inside here, it's like you're being transported off into a different time and a different place. And that was one of the great things about Sid, is he wanted the audiences to get more than just a regular movie experience. He wanted to give them sort of a theatrical dinner, as he put it.
Apparently, the American government asked, you know, to the Chinese if it was possible to import those kind of art pieces. Right?
Yeah. Sid Grauman actually had to get permission from both the Chinese government and the U.S. government, and he actually, including our two Chinese Heaven's Dogs out front, a lot of different pagodas and artifacts were actually brought over, and he got get permission from both governments.
I mean, this is quite something, you know?
It really is, and there's nothing that beats seeing a movie inside this theater.
It's like a usual movie when you know that, you know, the Oscars were taking place here in the 40s. It's quite an experience to come and watch a movie.
Exactly, and when you watch a movie inside here, we have a screen that's one of the widest commercial movie theater screens in the world. It's actually about 90 feet wide when it's fully open up, about 50 feet high. And it looks absolutely amazing when you're seeing
so comfortable
those.
As well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the chairs recline back, and the chairs are the same style they were back in 1927.
Okay, now let's focus, okay? Mm-hmm. Back in the 19, we're gonna relax.
Oh, okay.
So did you ever imagine working in this, you know, dream environment?
You know, I've been very fortunate when I've been here. It's just an amazing place, and I never would have pictured when I was a kid I'd get a chance to work in such an amazing and historic movie palace. I mean, this is such a big part of movie history, and to get to be a part of that on a daily basis by showing it off to people from all around the world, it really is a dream. It's really cool to get to share all this history and everything behind it.
I heard that basically, one of the very famous actresses back in the 20s walked in the Simon by mistake and then left, you know, our footprint, and that's how the whole story began.
Yeah, right down here, Norma Talmadge. She was walking through, stepped into the wet cement. Sid Grauman saw that, and the idea struck him as an accident, just walking right there. And so he went ahead and had her go ahead and do it a second time. Write her name down there, and she wrote an endearment, and then post-dated it for May 18th, which was the opening day of the theater. But that's how it all began, a complete accident back in 1927.
So it's very nice to have left, you know, a little spot for my footprint.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Everybody's here to this big day today.